Good morning. I would like to thank the organization for inviting me to take part in this important meeting. I am especially grateful to two colleagues, Professor Mimi Bueno and Luz Laporte, who rely on my work. And appreciate my contribution as a freelance and professional archaeologist in the resort and intervention in the megalithic monument. Secondly, I have to apologize for my poor level of spoken English and French. Due to this, I'm going to read my intervention in how the images display about spawn. In this presentation, I introduce a number of consideration about the architectonic feature and construct system of the megalithic monuments in the Ester and Dévalo. This is a geographical region located in the southwest of the Iberian Peninsula. The exposition will focus on three main objectives. The first, general characterization of the megalithic and dolmenic groups in this region. Second, the study of the architectonic typologies, constructive system, and working techniques in relation to the cultural identities and building habits. Third, analysis of the transformation processes, building phases, and monumentalization of the most important megalithic groups. Well, Block 1. The province of Huelva stands out due to the number and diversity of megalithic typologies, with the system of standing stone, stone circles, dolmens, curved tombs, and hypogeums. This area has architectonic feature and constructive system which are too similar to some other appearing of the Atlantic facade or recent prehistory from the 5th to the 2nd millennium. In the province, the Ester and Dévalo are located located in southwestern border of Sierra Morena, where a peculiar funerary megalithic site formed by dolmenic groups distributed on the valleys of the tributary brooks of the rivers Tinto and Odiel. In this region, we could highlight the following groups: El Pozuelo, El Villar, Los Gabrieles, El Gallego, Onueco, and Las Huecas. According to paleomental data and archaeological research, these megalithic constructions were erected and used by farming communities, basically stone breeding, who inhabited in small scattered settlements. In this sense, dolmens can be considered a sacred space that justifies the physical and symbolic appropriation of the different areas of this megalithic territory. Generically, we can emphasize a series of general aspects about the architectural feature of the dolmenic groups. One, each group present the specific feature and their topographic location, architecture, constructive system, and work techniques, which may reflect the expression of the cultural identities and building tradition on every community or group that inhabited in this territory. Two, the special distribution of every group is for an organization of associated and weak hierarchical relationship according to their size, setting for megalithic landscapes. Thus, the highest and most complex structures are at the most prominent and relevant place, that is, in the middle. On the contrary, the smallest dolmens and two with simplest constructive isolation are usually on the least prominent areas around the most monumental structure. Three, existence of a territorial association between dolmens and rock engravings. Located and relevant outcropping rock close to traditional paths. The rock engravings could be a special demarcator of the transit areas or essential ceremonial space of the megalithic-like case. Important examples, a rock engraving, are son le aulacares, o petroglyph, pardon, el riscal. Four, existence of different typologies of dolmen architecture with a wide range of formal variation of internal megalithic structures. Five, for the construction of these megaliths, materials from the local geologic environment. For example, Los Gabrieles, we exploited in the Reda City. Six, pardon, a system of complex special articulation of external ritual practices, where stele and altars can be disposed with material deposition offerings. For instance, cruciform idols, plate, and hopper. These peculiar megalithics can be result of a funerary ideology, basis of ancestor commemoration and worship, embodied in the construction dolmen erected in many occasions on places with Neolithic occupation and previous uses, around with different and complex ritual practices were developed. For this reason, they were monuments and continuous, long-term and reputed use and different construction phases and architectural projects were carried out, which implied the continuous transformation of their architecture and external space. This result can be, has been published with my colleague Leonardo. The Olden's radiocarbon dated dolmen at the second half of the 4th millennium BC, dolmen de Casullo. At the beginning of the 3rd millennium, a fact inspection and consolidation of the different groups took place. As the millennium marched, there is an aggressive monumentalization in these megalithics. This tradition continued at the late Bronze Age, in the transition to the second millennium, a time when individual graves, six, are imposed in relation to hierarchical and unequal burial rites, what breaks with the megalithic tradition. Block two. In this block, we introduce a number of common features and specific cases related to the architectonic typologies, which characterize the building tradition and the technical styles that can be identified as work processes, in French, chain opératoire, resulting from how now, in French, savoir-faire, defining each dolmen ensemble in the Stern Ensemble. Feature one, the construction of the dolmens implies the realization of fitting out works on location, growth, grading, regularization of the land in the outcropping. Two, foundation ditches are usually continuous and deep, fitting in base to the placement and arrangement of each orthostas. Three, the orthostas and the capstone are made up blocks on stone from the local environment. Pardon. In many cases, the feature engraving and trace and painting on their surface, behind, in some cases, Neolithic stele integrated in the orthostatic construction. How you see? The orthostats were interlocked using internal wedges and external shoring slacks. The wedges are pebbles, cobbles, and boulders of high hardness and consistency, quartz, quartzite, and volcanic rocks. Diverse megalithic internal structures, simple longitudinal galleries, in French, à l'écouvert, dolmens with curved toward passive morphology, dolmen coudé, dolmens with supporting pillars, passage grades and multiple chamber, etc., as you say in the picture. The mounds are made of several rich stone for internal straining or superimposed layers of blocks of stone and clay. The caves are made of blocks integrating rock ice crocks or stalactites which are awkwardly thrust into the ground. For example, Dolmen Los Gabrieles and Dolmen El Pozuelo, Dolmen II de Pozuelo. We analyzed three cases in particular, the Dolmens Old Gallego, Los Gabrieles, y El Pozuelo. The most remarkable feature in the group of Dolmens El Gallego or Nueco are a system for longitudinal passage with the altars and initial strains. The external space and the access areas have paved ranks and traced vestibules. The mounds consist of two reinforced cement rings on constructed level and retaining its slats. The reinforced cement rings surrounding the prostatic structure made out of stone placed vertically. The space between them is filled with multiple layers of stone and clay. The retaining slats are places of an external edge of the moon, serving a constructive element for the formation of the mound. As you see, Puerto de los Huertos Dolmen and Casullo, a similar construction. In the case of the group El Pozuelo, we highlight construction of Pasha's tomb with central supporting pillar, construction of Pasha's dolmen and several chambers. For example, dolmens with two chambers, dolmens with cruciform plan, dolmens with four chambers or several chambers. In the group number two from Los Gabrieles, some dolmens stand out with an internal orthostatic structure with curved toward passes, with a similar size in the entrance passage and chambers, with two slats closing the structure. Their access facing north. This constructive solution comes from an evolutionary process and the transformation of the megalithic group. Thus was Montulus said in the second half of the third millennium BC, as documented from the excavation of Dolmen IV. The persisting dolmen remaining integrated in the middle of the megalithic chamber, as you see in this picture. Okay. Similar dolmen big erected in parallel to transformation process Dolmen IV, Dolmen IV, following the same constructive parameters. Block 3. In this block, we focus on the group Los Llanetes, belonging to the megalithic complex of El Pozuelo, Zalamea Real. The group Los Llanetes is formed by four dolmens located in the east end of the group El Pozuelo, under the shelter and southern slope of the high top of the Chinflón, where the well-known copper trench mines are. Several housing areas sign the last Neolithic till the Bronze Age. The system settlement signed prehistory is also stressed, from which the graph visualization over the megaliths and the surrounding territory because it's the one of the most remarkable peaks of the Ester and the Valo. Dolmens are distributed in pairs, in topographic localization different to the right and the left margins of the head of the Agua Fría Ravine, a tributary watercourse of the Rio Tinto. Dolmens 1 and 2 are located in the peaks of the two hills and dolmens 3 and 4 on a promontory on the slope and Chinflón, surrounding the mountain fog hills. The only outdoor space faced toward east, and dolmens they have open and clear horizon in direction to the rising sun. In addition, it's remarkable that the dolmens are located in the geological center of the contact between two geological formations, in the Iberian Pirit Belt, the volcanic sedimentary complex with volcanic rocks and the size, dolerites and gabbros, greenfleet and slate, the slate and quartzite group, with slate, sandstone, and high density and quartz. The archaeological excavation carried out in Dolmen 3 and 4 in the year 2010 allowed to identify the existence of the monumental megalithic enclosure with highly complex structure and space. A made dolmen surrounding by three perimeter terraces, provided with closing walls at each and rung of the entrance area, paved transit areas, altars, and still well here to place. All of the erected in different constructive phases. Okay. Third phase, megalithic Neolithic site from the 4th millennium or possibly earlier. So far, some remains of Aline stele have been documented under the funerary level of the Dolmen 3 behind the northwest-southwest axis. That is facing the winter solstice. Therefore, some form of alignment of stele may have filetes of different size and morphologies. The steles have been documented a fracturate on the base sign zone twin and have been reused as orthostat assuring slacks. Second phase, construction of the Dolmen 4 and the ditch at the beginning of the third millennium. The Dolmen 4 has an internal megalithic structure with three elements spatially differentiated, passage and the chamber, with internal floor and access the step box covering on a slate. This structure is inside a medium-sized mound of clay and stone, delimited by gravestone supported a platform. As you see. I stand out three elements: the regularity in the form and typology of his orthostat, made of fillet. The use of supported pillars has a constructive solution for a better stability of the caston at the grid chamber. A similar solution is to the one in the Dolmen Mega Antequera. Steles integrate possibly older, which has been fractured for its usage as a learning element for the caston. Stele integrate anthropomorphic stele with round edge carved, a similar typology to certain idol plates found in different areas of the Iberian Peninsula. Heading north from the dolmen, a grid ditch down of the rock has been documented. We may have a different fashion, as happened with the green Mount Ergrat, French. Third phase, monumentalization of the megalithic enclosure, construction of the Dolmen 3 and the external terrace platforms. In this phase, many constructive actions carry out with the aim of the monumentalization and increasing the size of the megalithic enclosure. The Dolmen 3 has a peculiar internal structure made of passage vein facing southwest that gives a antechamber and two chambers. It sits inside a prominent round mound delimited by a cairn, with paving connected to external cairn made of the three raw materials, phyllites, andesite, and quartz. His host of that hangs an stele whole engraving and remains of the red paintings currently under the study by Professor Primitiva Bueno, Mimi Bueno, and Rodrigo Palvin. In the entrance area, they're used to the quadrangular stipic altar, which was attached to the northern section of the cairn. In this strip of the cairn, the dolmen show thin, long flagstones that were placed more vertically. The result is a type of entrance façade. Opening of the quarry towards the south of the dolmen for the slate extraction to build the mound. Arrangement of perimeter terrace of platform provided with retaining walls. And, pardon, and paving made of small flagstone of phyllite and quartz. So was rammed naked in the slate crowd with steles and hairs. Full face transformation in the megalithic enclosure. The atrium was modified in dolmen for placing a stele on the left side, vertically anchored in foundation pit, with a small quadrangular altar. That is constructed isolation similar to Les Pierres Plates, Los Mariaquer. A few meters away, in the external entrance space, a stele altar was placed in association to hearth delimited by stone structure. Dolmen 3, the altar was modified where an stone structure was arranged next to the cairn. It has documented some burning episodes. In the last Bronze Age, a time of intense exploitation, the copper mines on Chiflón were the actions. Dolmens, despoiling and destruction, cast-stone removal, orthostat breaking, has indicated the existence of the meaning hearthstone of the level alteration and destruction. But funerary reusing and resacralization of the sites communicate the existence of the great peak covered with cobble stone between the dolmens. The raw materials of the local geological environment used in the construction slate outcropping within the enclosure, green felix, quartz, andesite, and clay. These constructive faces can also appear in the dolmens 1 and 2 in Los Llanetes. We will study in the future. Due to all this, we believe that the group in Los Llanetes defines itself as a specific megalithic last case, where all elements array a ritual scenario whose usage and function must be understood as sacred space consolidated for several functions, in use for millenniums. At the beginning, third millennium is the moment the crisis monumentalization. We will shortly come to two general aspects and the use, reuse, and destruction of the megalithic monuments in the transition from the third to the second millennium. The destruction or condemnation of some monuments. For example, Dolmen of Puerto de los Huertos. In this site, we are detected the dismantling of the mound structure, sandstone and remold. And remold, the systematic breaking to ground level orthostat. Finally, three conclusions. The Eastern Aldebalo is a megalithic territory characterized by the existence of the dolmen groups with their home architectonic typologies, constructive systems and materials. Two, several communities existed in the area who built megaliths using very strong traditional techniques and very old cultural identities, presumably from the Neolithic period. Third, the Eastern Aldebalo and the province of Huelva has area for research of megaliths in the Iberian Peninsula and their connection to the European Atlantic passage during the recent prehistory are great important. Thank you so much.